So, well, admittedly, we do have... Thank you very much, I was looking for those. So while we do have some of our musicians... Oh, one more. While some of our alumni are professional musicians or still play on a regular basis, most of our alumni haven't played in a while. And when we put the call out to alumni, we were overwhelmed. Yes, Evan's here too. We were overwhelmed with the number of former band students who were willing to dust off the old instruments and give it a go for Mrs. Evelyn Young. We are going to take a moment to warm up before we begin. As you look about, you'll see on some of the music stands, class of 2003, the different classes that you see on the different music stands. Until you did what she wanted you to do. I first saw her work with my sister-in-law, Daniela Schasser, on Carney's first ever musical, Joseph and the Amazing Technicolor Dreamcoat. And as an audience member, I saw that show and I wanted it. I wanted to be a part of that. I clearly had no idea what I was getting myself into. But I'm very glad that I did. Evelyn oversaw the expansion of the band and choir programs, musicals, plays, trips and art displays, the growth of the drama program, the establishment of the media arts program, and the eventual construction of our musical. She didn't do it single-handed. It's not as though all of these things were necessarily her idea, but that's her thing. You see, often, I don't believe that Evelyn necessarily knew what was happening in my drama classes. But she saw that students were happy, that they were safe, that they were improving, that there were good results in their performance. So she asked, how can I help? What do you need? How can I help? Then she let me go to work. She was the first one with a compliment. She was never afraid to redirect me. And she always supported my crazy ideas. That is her vision. It's big picture. She sees the spark, even when we don't. She fans the flames until you shine like a star. That is the teacher that I aspire to be. That's what I learned from Evelyn. Don't see the job, or the colleague, or the student today. Have a vision of what they can be tomorrow.
It isn't something that can be taught or learned in university. And while it seems like a simple enough concept, in practice, demonstrating compassion at all times as a teacher is a tall order. It requires devotion, self-sacrifice, and lots of patience, qualities which can sometimes be hard to muster when you are facing a room full of teenagers. I began my career in Carney in September 2004. And if you're hearing The Circle of Life from The Lion King, that's because that happened to be Mrs. Webster's grade 12 grad year. So we've come full circle. I started as a first-year teacher armed with all kinds of knowledge and only the ignorance that a 23-year-old university graduate could possibly have. I knew my theory, I had taken pedagogy courses aplenty, and I could play a paradiddle on a snare. And I was pretty sure I could solve all of my students' problems with this. And then I met Emily, and I quickly realized that my education was not over. It had only just started. Watching Evelyn Forever Young teach, I immediately realized that this was a bigger job than I had thought. Evelyn's kindness, caring, and willingness to help others permeates everything she does at the school. I have watched her wrangle dozens of students armed with instruments into focus and musicianship in the relentless pursuit of meaningful performance. Daily, Evelyn shows her students that she cares too much about them to let them get away with anything but their best. I have seen her deliver honest and frank feedback, sometimes hard to hear, with love and hope, leaving the person on the receiving end of her words with a full understanding of what is needed for improvement and the faith that they are capable of making the change. Often, I've been on the receiving end of this myself. Evelyn is the first to pitch in where she can. Each year, rain or shine, she marches that band out onto the field for the championship finals of the BC Catholics, armed with tents, Washington and Lee Swing, the final countdown, and pure moxie. It's important to her not only to carry out her own vision at the school, but with compassion, she shows others that she cares enough about them to help them carry out their mission too. Her selflessness and helpful nature extends far beyond the school. When my husband Ethan and I were first married and had just bought our first townhouse, we scrambled to get it ready before moving in. On the day we were to paint our bedroom, Evelyn called me that morning saying, "Ella, I'm in the parking lot, and I brought my own roller. I hope that's okay." Who shows up to paint your house after knowing you for a year? I mean, she's just one of a kind. That's a thing. Our relationship quickly stretched beyond the walls of our school and into friendship, and now she is part of my family. We often joke about how no one can say no to Mrs. Young. She is a natural saleswoman and can persuade anyone to buy 50-50 tickets, get them to take up bowling, or try the bacon-wrapped tenderloin from Newfound Farms, or the turtle cheesecake. Equally good, equally good. And as funny as that is, though, there's an explanation for this magical ability of hers. No one can say no to her because she has never, ever said no to us. Oddly enough, no one in my entire career has ever asked me to play paradiddle on a snare drum. And even though I use my theoretical knowledge daily, theory and knowledge does not a good teacher make. Good teaching is motivated by vision, but it is fueled by compassion. And Evelyn has compassion in spades.
Thank you. I have known Evelyn for about 18 years now. My family and I had just moved to Port Coquitlam, and I started at Carney in the ninth grade. I can actually remember walking into my first band class with Evelyn in the old portable. I remember walking into class and she was asking me all of the usual band teacher questions. What instrument do you play? How long have you been playing them for? Do you play any other instruments? My answers were flute for 4 years and piano since I was 3. She gave me this look of amazement, and I knew from that moment on that she would be a very important person in my life. She taught me so much musically as a high school student, but it wasn't until after high school where she really left an impression, and my mind was set that I needed to be the person who would take over her job when she retired. I'm pretty sure I've been saying that since the day I graduated. We had always stayed in contact, and I would always come back and play either the piano or the oboe in the pit orchestra for the musicals. And it wasn't until May of 2014 when Evelyn had asked me to conduct the pit orchestra for Seussical. I'd like to think she asked me because of the continuous conducting, and some of you who would rap, I think you were there, you would remember, it was literally non-stop music. The continuous conducting that I had to do, and I maybe thought she might have been a little bit lazy to do it. But I knew deep down that she wanted to give me this amazing opportunity to get more experience as a teacher and to potentially prepare me for possible musicals in the future. Let's fast forward a few more years, and I'm now working with the lady who inspired me to become who I am today. I get to be mentored by the forever young, and ever since my first day, she has taken me under her wing, looking out for me. Over the past 2 years, Evelyn has taught me so much, but one thing I've realized from working with her was that no matter the greatness of one's playing skills or what his or her understanding of music may be, it's the passion of the band that completes the melody. Her passion for music that she has shown us throughout her teaching years, her love for every person in the ensemble will always stay in our heart, strengthening every single one of us. We've all seen her singing to the music, waving her arms like crazy, or dancing on stage. We even made a dance out called the Evelyn. Evelyn, we will always remember the passion you had for your job, the music, and your students that you taught, me being one of them. You have inspired so much more in me that I hope one day I can be as amazing, passionate, humble, and inspiring as you have been. You have helped me in my life journey towards becoming a music educator, and you will forever be.
May the good Lord be with you down every road you roam, and may sunshine and happiness surround you when you're far from home.
Be courageous and be brave, and in our hearts, you'll always stay
forever young. Evelyn? We found your keys.
Thank you. it's really funny, Andy, turn up here for the keys, and what many of you don't know here tonight is I'm going to lost your keys today. And seriously, you can't make this stuff up. We have the office looking for her keys, asking us. We're in the office talking about scheduling for next year, and she's, you see my keys? Well, then we haven't. But just before, today? She just said, I was all over the place today. Just today? She's all over the place today. But just before we invite you into the MPR for some refreshments and some cake, just a couple quick things about the kids and everybody else that came back here today. First of all, it's fantastic for me to see so many alumni here that I taught all too long ago, and that many of us taught all too long ago. But it's very, very good to see so many of you coming back, so thank you very much for coming back and being here. Those alumni that have come back, if you wouldn't mind just standing for a quick second so she can see all of who's here. My first time here as a teacher, I was athletic director and basketball coach and spent my life in this gym. And on the nights when these events would happen, at that time they happened in the gym every year. And I often felt like, oh, I should probably go, but it often gave me a rare night off of practice or games and like to be home with my family and that kind of thing. So I didn't really go to very many of them. And being here the last two nights and for the Christmas one, I can't tell you, I said this last night and then in the Christmas concert as well, I'm absolutely blown away by the talent of this school. It's just phenomenal how good these students sound, playing their instruments, working together, and singing together. It's phenomenal. And again, I relate a lot of things back to sports, and I know that teamwork that's required to succeed in a basketball game is not unlike the teamwork that's required to succeed in this. And the practice that it takes to succeed in basketball is the same as it takes to succeed in this. And so the amount of time that all of you have put in, and when I say all of you, everybody here, including the alumni, have put in to your craft, to getting better, to sounding better, is very, very evident to everybody here. We're not just clapping because it's a nice thing to do. We're clapping because you deserve it. The amount of time that you've spent and the amount of work that you've put in over the years is very, very evident. And while it's got to be guided by people who know what they're doing, and that's, of course, Evelyn and Mrs. Treberry, Mrs. Lester, and Mr. Harris, at the same point, the talent that is shown by you guys comes out as well. So congratulations on a fantastic two nights. And again, thank you so much for coming. And we have some cake and some refreshments in the NPR. We invite all of you back there over there following this. So again, thank you very much for coming and enjoying it.
Please note there is also a guest book for you to sign in the NPR. And God bless.